Hey, this is the XRP Cowboy. Hey, this is Billy. We're gonna put the cowboy to sleep tonight. We don't need any violence or profanity. This is all Billy tonight. We won't let the cowboy out. Alexis, start song over.
Rape me again. I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one.
My dreamers, my fucking roadies, the light above your face is incredible. Please forgive me.
The light above your face, it's incredible. Please forgive me. You're making me want it so bad. You're making me want it so bad. I smell a sweet fragrance about you, and I know that you want it too. So if I reach back and lay it to you, please forgive me.
My dreamers, there's so much going on in this world. There's so many things to talk about. You know, where do we start? How do we start? You know? I don't know where to begin, but I will read something to you that I read today that was beautiful. I mean, we're going to talk about Jim for a minute. We're going to talk about XRP, how it's going to go to 5K very easily in a minute. We're going to break it down with some information, with some words. What do we do here? Do we just skip this? There's just so many things. I had something marked, but then we lost it. We lost it, my dreamers. We'll never hear these beautiful words. Portrait of a knife. Can't do that. What can we do? Sorry to be wasting so much of your time. Anything lost can be found but time, my dreamers. Fuck it. Let's get into it. Let's get down to business. All right, you guys, I have a video I want to play, and then I'm going to give you my opinion. We're going to be nice tonight. We're not going to say anything mean, nothing violent. But I just found this very interesting. I know I've brought some YouTubers into this video, into my stream, but they worded so beautifully. Now, this guy's about to tell you how XRP could go to 1,200 very easily. You ready for this? Better get ready. Now, this is Brad Kynes. If you've seen this, it's okay. It's not the end of time. You should see it again. Let me shut my... It's freezing in my garage. But here we go. Ready?
Clip just play because it is fantastic. So I'm just going to let it go. Here it is. necessarily think you have to peg it to a stable coin, because really what you're doing is you've got one stable fiat currency over here and another stable fiat currency over here, right? Where XRP is valuable fiat currency over here.
Sorry,
right?
Trying to get it better.
Where XRP's value is determined, I mean, I've seen this sort of simple calculation, but Swift currently, I think the number is it settles 1.2 quadrillion with a Q, quadrillion dollars a year.
Quadrillion.
And that is the amount of money that gets moved. It's not necessarily the market cap of how much money we have. It's how many times does it get circulated, right? And if you have $1.2 quadrillion, let's say, for example, the Ripple's, you know, the XRP ledger system carves out 10% of that. That's $120 trillion, right? And if XRP, let's just say, for example, the total unit supply of XRP is in the marketplace at 100 billion.
Let's just hear that again.
Right? And if XRP, let's just say, for example, the total unit supply of XRP is in the marketplace at 100 billion. Well, if you take 120 trillion and you divide it by 100 billion, how many times is XRP moving? How much is it moving a unit, the unit of value? It's moving at 1,200 times, right? So each individual XRP is moving 1,200 times. So wouldn't it be fair to say that that is an enormous value? And so that value would be $1,200 per XRP if it's moving $120 trillion. So you have to look at it that way. The volume of its utility is defining the value of what the currency currently is. The stability of it is really making sure that XRP's price stays stable within the marketplace. But the other advantage that the ledger provides is if you're dealing with on-demand liquidity, so you're only borrowing the XRP for the time that you're using it. Again, you're the investment of having to do cross-border payments just gets cut in exponentially in cost. So I hope that makes more sense, where the value of the utility bridge currency is a little bit different because it's based on the volume of how much it turns.
Success doesn't have to. My dreamers, I'm understanding what he's saying, but I'm not smart enough. The fucking cowboy's not smart enough. I'm not, okay, we're swearing. We're not going to get violent. The cowboy's not smart enough to know if that's factual, but he's, you know, he's sitting there with a great board, so I have to believe what he's saying is true about the volume and everything in the price. And I guess there's a certain degree of, you know, supply. You know, if the whole supply is constantly moving, you know, I mean, the price is going to go up. But this is the interesting thing, my dreamers. Let's just pretend he's half right. Now, I don't know if he said 5 or 10%. Would make XRP, if Swift used 5 or 10%, would make XRP $1,200. Well, what if he's half right? It's just 5 or 10% only? That would make it $600? Fucking to the moon, fucking baby. Yeah, fuck you, everybody that I've pissed off in this space. We're all winning. We're all winners, guys. You know? There's another narrative. Why it's so much more what he's saying. If Swift did use 5 or 10%, whatever the fuck that guy said, they would see the efficiency, the money's being saved, the quickness, the lightning speed, fucking eye of the tiger shit, guys. Here's what we're missing. It won't be long before they're using it for 50% of their money transfers, eventually 100%. Now, this is where things do get a little more serious. If they're just using it for 5 or 10, like you said, and they go to 20 or 10%, the price is $2,400. So if we go to, you know, double that, Just can you imagine that 10,000K is in play once they totally integrate into using XRP? It's if what he is saying is true, even if he's half right or a quarter right, we got a 2,000 XRP, my dreamers. This is fucking very interesting. Very interesting for all the moon boys. The big question everybody keeps saying and talking about, and you guys, my dream is you've heard this. You may have been the first ones to hear this. I know when I came up with the idea, you know, I was listening to Brad when everyone was saying XRP was going to replace Swift. I'm like, they're not going to, because Brad said they don't want to, you know, own companies. They don't want to do. They want to partner with everybody because they want a, you know, they don't want to be competing. They want to have everyone embrace their technology. Like Bill Gates with Microsoft. They want to own the fucking whole financial system. You can't do that competing. You have to partner. So it was logic, basic fucking logic that they were going to partner. But the interesting thing is, guys, my dreamers, they're already partnered with Swift. Who owns Swift? The banks. The banks. The fucking banks, my fucking roadies, the banks. The banks. Who are the banks partnered with? Ripple. They're already partnered. No one's getting hurt by Swift running on Ripple. This is what, you know, people are not talking about enough. And, you know, I know it's a ramble, but this is something that's huge. Now, we got to take it to one more step further with a little speculation. I got one more quick thing I want you to see. We'll get into that. But it's important. My dreamers, we broke through that 39 resistance we were talking about on Bitcoin. Market's going up. Last time I checked, it was 41.5. It's moving really good. It's up fucking a shit ton in the last 24 hours. I would like to see it test 39.5 one more time, give or take a plus or minus 1,000. There is no pinpoint number, guys. We'd like to think there is, but people come in early and they, you know, or they get greedy and they wait a little longer. It's all coordinated. But I'd like to see that retest. Let's just call it 39.5 plus or minus 1,000 and then pop right back up. Then we know we're fucking, you know, we're safe. We want the 39.5 to be a new level of support. Then it'll take us up to the fucking mid-40s. And then we got one more leg up and then things start moving quick. ATH. Here we go. Watch. I'm not the only one. So here's something else I saw today on one of our friends' channel. I'm just going to do a little adage with some cowboy vision to this one, too.
Really important. This is the Federal Reserve and how the Fed ties into Ripple and really the financial system of the future as they usher this in. We see the following. Move towards digital dollar gains steam as Boston Fed says its prototype can handle 1.7 million transactions per second. It's no... you know, secret that the Fed, that the United States government, they want to take us to a cashless society. That way they can track, trace, and monitor, you know, all of our transactions. It's also going to help, you know, lower the tax gap. They can see everything that's going on. If you make a dollar, they're going to see it. There's no off-ledger transactions like we see now with cash. They want to end it for a lot of reasons, really. And it's going to be more efficient, lower costs. There's a lot of benefits to government and business to go cashless, and we're going there. Again, it's not going to happen overnight, but it's going to be a transition period. Maybe a decade, maybe a decade and a half. It's going down. And the Federal Reserve, they understand this. And trust me, they are working with Ripple. But look at this. Who are they working with on this prototype? This is also interesting. It doesn't matter. Just like my buddy DM Logic said, in any rock you overturn, you're going to find Ripple under there. Look at this. MIT and the Federal Reserve and this collaboration have shown technological viability of a Fed-backed digital dollar, also known as central bank digital currency. And look at this. The system they have supposedly can do 1.7 million transactions per second, according to the white paper released Thursday. That's 2.5 times the number of transactions Visa can handle with its network. Furthermore, the vast majority of these transactions were settled in less than 2 seconds, a tantalizing result for users in the U.S. banking system, which can force customers to wait days before fund transfers are settled. Now, this is what's so interesting. We know the Federal Reserve, of course, Faster Payments Task Force, all of that, has worked with Ripple, great. But who has funded the MIT blockchain department? The department that Gary Gensler, the SEC, used to have, who was one of their big contributors. Ripple, they gave millions of dollars to MIT to go out there and build blockchain systems. And I know people are going to say, hey, these are domestic transactions. I still say those are going to, you know, be routed through RippleNet for a lot of reasons. But beyond that, any great domestic system in the future is going to have capabilities of going international. You have to link up with international payments. It's just the wave of the future. As we go to this really globalized economy, it's not going to be any more just domestic payments. Payments are going to need to go wherever they're sent, and they're going to have to go there in real time. And so as we see the Federal Reserve with their eye on a fully digital dollar, it's going to happen. The Fed is going to demand that it happens. They're going to cut costs. Government's going to get all the tracking and tracing and monitoring that they need.
Here's the thing, guys. You were just listening to Jungle. You know, I got to be careful what I say about fucking Jungle Inc., because this motherfucker is connected, guys. I'm telling you, in ways, I mean, he's up there. You know, I talk to him all the time, but after every conversation, he likes to joke. And he says, Cowboy, remember, I have your fucking address. Just saying, guys, that smoke and mirror shit, he knows some shit. But besides that, so I got to be a little careful, you know. This is a thing that people aren't talking about. Yes, with a digital dollar, they're saying, you know, a digital dollar in a central bank digital currency, it's one and the same. Okay, that's fine. It's great. You know, they're implying, and it's definitely, you know, Ripple, XRP, whether it's a private ledger or the federated ledger, whatever you want to fucking call this shit, mine as well. But the truth is the fucking truth. And, this shit is more serious than people understand. Remember, every pressure has an equal and opposing pressure. You fucking punch a wall, that energy comes right back into your hand equally. And all the good that's going to be fucking great from our lucky charms, you know, our fucking time coins, there's going to be equal bad. So they're talking about how they're going to know all the money you make and all this shit. But I'm telling you, there's something else they're not talking about. And you don't hear anyone talking about this. Sure, they're going to be able to track the money coming in and where you're spending it. But it's so much bigger than that. Let's just throw a fucking situation out there. I mean, are we going to even need accountants anymore when all this stuff is fully integrated? Is that something that's going to die off? Think about this. They're going to know what you spend and where you spend it. But more importantly, that's fine. This is the narrative. You know, I believe they're going to bring the taxes down on a little bit on everything. People are going to, just to initiate this digital dollar, this central bank currency, our taxes may get lowered. But the thing is like, you know, Jungle said, they're going to know all the money you make. So they're going to be taxing everybody on every fucking dollar they make. Every fucking dollar. And this is a problem because that's one thing. So they're going to effectively make more money from me and you. Or the masses. But this is the other thing. And maybe the wealth will get fucking hit up. We'll get into that. But maybe not in this video. But ultimately, you're spending. Think about this. You don't have to pay taxes anymore. They're just going to take it out. And imagine this. And, you know, we have a certain degree of freedom to spend money on what we want. If we have a parking ticket. We have, and I'm not saying you shouldn't pay child support payment due. We have money we owe to the IRS or the state. And we're just kind of juggling. We got to pay our mortgage first or, you know, just put food or keep the lights fucking on. We won't have that luxury to push that bill aside. And we shouldn't with our kids. I get that. But what they have the ability and the capability of doing is every time you purchase something, whether it's food, even a fucking utility, they have the ability to take a percentage off the top every time you spend, or you just won't be able to pay your bill. And you will not have a fucking choice. They'll be able to track every fucking thing. So if you have a fucking state bill due for fucking tax or something, they could take 20% of every fucking purchase you make.
depending on your financial system. Maybe they'll have a set of rules for that. You guys, this is serious shit. It's something we need to think about, something we can't change, but we're invested in. You know, I got into this knowing this was a capability, but my thought was if I can't fucking beat them, fucking make money from these motherfuckers. You know, I watch these motherfuckers all the time. Like I said, I'm not going to say anything violent, but I will say this. When fucking Jim Cramer was talking with Gary Gensler and they were bitching about us making money, what, 9% on our fucking money? Jim acted like he was the fucking government. We can't let him do that. We can't. That's all I could hear. It was so hard, the mumbling that he was saying. I heard, we can't let him do this. Put your dick fucking deeper down my throat, fucking Gary. I want to grab your fucking balls, bitch. Fuck you, Jim Cramer. You guys don't listen to this motherfucker. This motherfucker is, he's not your friend. I know this is probably not the way I wanted this video to go, but there's a certain degree of truth. Sorry, I sound like fucking Jim with Gary's little cock in his mouth. You guys, I just care. I got a family. We don't want to be controlled. We're already being fucking tracked. You know, Snowden, Eagle Eye, all that fucking shit. What do you think they're doing to us with Facebook and everything? Who fucking, Mark Zuckerberg probably is fucking Eagle Eye Facebook. Fuck. I'll probably get this video taken down. But, my dreamers, I love you. Just a quick little rant. Hadn't had any whale's blood, so I'm sorry if this video wasn't that good. But no, the Cowboys got love for you. Alexa, play Highway 20 Ride.
Here's Highway 20 Ride by Zac Brown Band.
My son's song. That sucked, this video. Sorry, guys.
I ride east every other Friday. And if I had it my way, a day would not be wasted on this drive. I want so bad to hold you. Some of these things I haven't told you. Your mom and me couldn't get along. So I drive and I think about my life and wonder why that I slowly die inside every time I turn that truck around. Right at the Georgia line, I count the days and the miles back home to you on that Highway 20 ride, my dreamers. A day may come you realize if you could see through my eyes. There was no other way to work it out. A part of you might hate me, but some, please don't mistake me for a man that couldn't care at all. And I drive and I think about my life and wonder why that I slowly die inside every time I turn that truck around. Right at the Georgia line, I count the days and the miles back home to you on that Highway 20 ride.
Love you, son. You guys, hold your kids, they're growing so fast. Alexa off. In a minute, they'll be moving out.